my past can be swept away in the current of your mercy. And I know I'll never be the same. There's no limit to your promise. Jesus, you have done it all for me. Jesus, you have done it all for me. Grace comes like a wave crashing over me. Grace comes like a wave crashing over and over and over. Woo! Sing, I will jump. I will jump into the water where my soul can be satisfied. And your love is overflowing from within me and it won't run dry. There's no limit to your promise. Jesus, you have done it all for me. Jesus, you have done it all for me. In the water with a love that flows so deep, wash over me, wash over me. Salvation in the water with a love that flows so deep, wash over me, wash over me.
So deep, wash over me, wash over me. Forgiveness in the water, with a love that flows so deep. Wash over me, wash over me. Salvation in the water, with a love that flows so deep, wash over me, wash over me. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for your grace, Lord. Thank you, hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah.
We pray that today, God, tuning
nga, Panginoon, na yung presensya, Panginoon, ang sumasama sa amin, ang pumupuno sa amin, God. Lord, we just pray, God, that as we worship you today, Lord, that as we lift your presence, Lord, punuin nyo kami, God. May you fill, Lord God, the void in our hearts, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
When the heart is under fire, another way when the walls are closing in. And when I look at the space between where I used to be and this reckoning, I know I will never be alone. There was another in the fire. Standing next to me, there was another in the waters, holding back the seas. And should I ever need reminding of how I've been set free, there is a cross that bears no burden, where another died for me. There is another in the fire. There is another, oh Jesus. Oh, my dead left for dead beneath the waters. I'm no longer a slave to my sin anymore. And should I fall in the space between what means of me in this reckoning, either way I won't bow to the things of this world. I know I will never be alone. There is another in the fire standing next to me. There is another in the waters holding back to sea. Should I ever need reminding what power set me free? There is a grave that holds nobody. Now the power lives in me. There is another in the fire.
Says that there's no other name but the name that is Jesus. So right now, as we declare this, let's really believe in this, that there is no other name that can save us, that there is no other name that can love us, but only the name of Jesus.
There is no other name but the name that is Jesus. He was and still is and be true it all. So come on, may in this place between all the things unseen, in this reckoning, I know I will never be alone.
Come on, let's sing it again. There's no other name.
There is no other name but the name that is Jesus.
Come on, let's declare this.
He was and still is and will be through it all.
Jesus.
So come on, may in this space between all the things unseen, in this reckoning, I know I will never be alone. Sing it one more time. I know that I know.
Joy, come every battle, 'cause I know that's where you'll be. And I can see the light in the darkness as the darkness bows to Him. I can hear the roar in the heavens as the space between where sin. I can feel the ground shake beneath us as the prison walls give in. Between us, nothing stands between us. Oh, nothing stands between us. Oh, nothing, nothing, Lord. And it look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. Come on, declare this. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. This is how I find my battles. Oh, this is how.
This is how I find my battles.
This is how. This is how I find my battles.
This is how I find my battles,
yeah. This is how I find my battles. Come on, let this be a battle cry to you.
This is how I find my battles.
This is how I find my battles. This is how. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. This is how I find my battles. Oh, this is how I find my battles, Lord. Singing your song to the Lord. Surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you.
find my battles. If this is how we fight our battles, Lord.
Oh,
as we worship you, Jesus. Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for the wonderful time of worship, God. Thank you for being with us, Lord. Maraming salamat muli, Panginoon, na pinaramdam mo, Panginoon, ang iyong presensya sa amin. God, right now, Lord God, I just pray, Lord, that whatever battles, Panginoon, na pinagdadaanan ng bawat isa, God, we just pray, Lord God, that this is how we fight our battles, by worshiping you, by honoring you, God. We just pray, God, that whatever is surrounding us, Lord, mas mangibabaw, Panginoon, ang iyong presensya, ang iyong pagmamahal, Lord. We just pray, God, sa service na to, Lord, we may encounter you, God, once again. And we may experience your overflowing love, your unending love for us, Lord. Lord, maraming salamat, God, na hindi mo kami iniiwan, Panginoon, sa bawat problema na aming pinagdadaanan. Lord God, tunay nga, Panginoon, that you are in the fire with us. Maraming salamat, God. You are with us. You are with us. And you will be with us, Lord. Just pray, God, that all throughout this service, Lord, mas maramdaman pa po namin, Lord God, ang iyong presensya, Lord God. Holy Spirit, fill us with thirst. We thirst for your presence, Lord. We thirst for your word, Jesus. Mangusap ka, Panginoon, sa bawat isa, God. Maraming salamat, Lord. And we just honor you, God. And we just praise your name, Lord. We lift up all the glory, all the highest and honor and praises to you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. All God's people say, amen.
And it's giving time. In 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 6 to 7, in the Amplified Version, it says, "Now remember this, he who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and he who sows generously that blessings may come to others will also reap generously and be blessed. Let each one give thoughtfully and with purpose, just as he has decided in his heart, not grudgingly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver and delights in the one whose heart is in his gift." One of the absolute principles that I have learned in the kingdom of God is the law of sowing and reaping. Meaning, kapag meron kang tinanim, malamang meron ka ring aanihin. Simple lang, kapag nagtanim ka ng apple, aani ka ng apple. Kapag nagtanim ka ng orange, malamang aani ka ng orange. Kapag nagtanim ka ng kabutihan, aani ka ng kabutihan. Kapag nagtanim ka ng kasamaan, malamang kasamaan din yung aanihin mo. So kapag nagtanim ka ng pera, malamang sa malamang, according to this principle, aani ka din ng pera. So meron po akong tanong para sa ating lahat ngayong hapon. Sino po dito ang aamin na ngayon o minsan wala o nawawalan siya ng pera o ng income? Kung ikaw yon, comment down below. Amen. Ngayong COVID pandemic, nakaranas po tayo ng matinding pagsubok, mostly in the area of our job, our career, and even in our finances. Dahil pandemic, naturally, our response will be to thrift and save, but the Word of God says otherwise. Imbis na magtago o maghigpit ka, mas kinakailangan pa nating lalong magtanim. Dahil kung hindi o wala kang itatanim, malamang wala ka rin aanihin. Amen. So malinaw po na kaya wala tayong inaani kasi wala naman tayong itinatanim. Yes, you may be right that our spending, especially in this season of pandemic, varies depending on our lifestyle, but that does not excuse us from giving what belongs to God. Amen? God's Word says in Malachi chapter 3, verse 10 to 12 in the Amplified Version, bring all tithes, the tenth of your income, into the storehouse, so that there may be food in my house, and test me now in this, says the Lord of hosts. If I will not open for you the windows of heaven and pour out for you so great a blessing until there is no more room to receive it, wow, then I will rebuke the devourer, insects or plagues for your sake, and he will not destroy the fruits of the ground, nor will your vine in the field drop its grapes before harvest, says the Lord of the hosts. All nations shall call you happy and blessed, for you shall be a land of delight. Napakaganda po ng verse na yon. God is challenging us, is commanding us to give our tithes no matter what, so that He can protect our income, our fruits, our harvest. And because of this, all nations, everyone will know that we are God's people, that we are chosen for the delight of our Lord. Simple lang po. Yung ating tithes, ipang tithes mo. Huwag mong ipangkain. Yung pangkain mo naman, huwag mo naman ibibigay. You know what? God delights to see us prosper financially and materially. But the only way to make it happen is through giving. Bakit? In 2 Corinthians chapter 9 verse 8, in 2 Corinthians chapter 9 verse 8, it says, and God is able to make all grace, every favor and earthly blessing come in abundance to you, so that you may always, under all circumstances, regardless of the need, have complete sufficiency in everything, being completely self-sufficient in Him, and have abundance for every good work and act of charity. We need to prosper, not for our own sake, but so we can abound for every good work. So we can give to the church, we can be a blessing to others, and so that we can buy gifts. So when we pray, we do not ask God to give us just enough. You know why? Because number one, wanting to have enough is actually a form of selfishness. Kung gusto mo yung blessing, sakto lang para sa'yo, eh mali po yan, selfishness po yan, kadamutan po yan. Next naman po, if we want God to bless us just enough, did you know that it is actually an insult in the nature and character of God? Because He is Jehovah Jireh, the God who provides, and He is El Shaddai, the all-sufficient God. All-sufficiency doesn't come from the church, nor your parents, nor the ministry, not even from your job, but from above. Alam niyo po, ngayong panahon ng pandemic, isa sa mga naging challenges ko ay ang pagkita ng pera o ang pagkakaroon ng income. Sino ba naman po ang hindi na challenge? Sino ba naman po ang hindi na apektuhan? Lahat naman po tayo, amen? For the past months, literally, I was earning zero income. But you know what? God faithfully provided for me. Hindi po ako nagutom. Amen. Alam niyo po, during this season of pandemic, kahit po hindi ako nag-earn, nagkaroon po ako ng desire to really give to God, na magbigay pa lalo kahit wala po akong income. Hindi ko po alam kung paano, but I asked God to open opportunities for me to earn so that I can give to Him, so that I can give to Him and to others. To be honest po, wala pa pong masyadong opportunities na dumarating sa akin. But I am believing in my heart that they will come and doors will be open. And so while waiting, I am choosing to give faithfully any amount that the Lord entrusts me with. I have decided in my heart to steward my blessing no matter how small or big they are, believing that as I continue to sow, eventually, I will also reap. Countless times, I have heard testimonies of people who have faithfully gave kahit walang-wala na sila, and eventually, you know what? God blessed them. merong nagkaroon ng bagong bahay, merong nagkaroon ng trabaho, ng increase sa kanilang sweldo, yung iba naman nagkaroon ng negosyo, at marami pang iba. And so I want to become like those people. I want to become that person who chose to honor and sought God first sa lahat ng sitwasyon at pagkakataon ng buhay niya, and in return, all other things were just added unto their lives. So right now, church, no matter what situation you are in, may income ka man o wala, may trabaho ka man o wala, may nagbukas man na opportunity sa'yo o wala pa, I am encouraging you, I am challenging you to give. So if you are ready, allow me to pray for you. Father in heaven, we thank you for this opportunity that you have given us to sow into your kingdom. We believe, God, that as we sow at the right time, we will reap a harvest if we do not give up, if we do not give up honoring you, pleasing you, and worshiping you, especially in this area, in the area of our finances, in the area of our giving. Trusting you that as we give what is due to you, you will also bless us as you have promised in your word that you will rebuke the devourer. And through this, people, all nations shall see that we are your people and that you have chosen us for your delight. Bless this time. Bless the seeds that we are giving you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. So how do we give? For those who would like to give their tithes and offerings, here are our options. Number one, we can do that through direct bank deposit. Next is through online transfer via GCash or mobile app of your bank. Unbound City Church account number is currently on our screen. Once done, kindly email the deposit slip or screenshot of your transaction to unboundcitychurch@gmail.com. So church, thank you for your time. Let us all give cheerfully to the Lord. God bless you.
Hi Church, my name is Ken and welcome to Unbound City Updates. We are halfway through the year 2020. Ang bilis ng panahon, di ba? Dalawang buwan na lang, lalabas na ulit si Jose Marichan. Kaya huwag ka nang papetiks-petiks pa. Madami tayong time sa Netflix, TikTok, YouTube at iba pa. Pero yung goals mo in life, parang walang masyadong time. Pero huwag ka mag-alala dahil sama-sama tayo sa quarantine journey na to. Kaya mark your calendars at sumama sa mga online activities natin. Every Sunday, Living Room Revival. This is our online Sunday service happening by exactly 3:30 p.m. Isama ang pamilya, kamag-anak, kaibigan at sama-sama tayong mag-praise and worship at makinig ng Word of God. And after that, we have our Sunday Zoom-in where we can fellowship and follow through what we have learned and received from the preaching. Everyone is welcome to join. Mamaya po isesend namin sa inyo yung Zoom link. So, kita-kits! Next, we encourage everyone to join the online churchwide Bible study with Pastor Konghi on the Book of Revelation. It is organized by City Harvest Church and it's live every Wednesday at 8 p.m. For more details, please see the poster that will be flashed on your screen. Next, makitambay sa Unite at sumali sa live chat at kwentuhan with Pastor Brandon and Coach Eileen, where we can talk about love, heartbreaks, leadership, influence, at marami pang iba. Every Thursday, 9:30 p.m. And every Fridays naman at 9 p.m. is puso surgery. Ihanda ang iyong puso para sa isang matinding operasyon from the greatest heart surgeon. Join our heartmates as we deal and heal the issues of your heart. And our online cell group and Bible studies are available every week. Come and have fellowship with us. We have cell groups for men, women, young professionals, and youth. If you are interested, you may reach us through Unbound City Church Facebook page for the schedules. At approach mo kung sino yung nag-invite sa'yo na manood ng Sunday service. At kung isa ka sa mga artsy-fartsy people, You wanna enhance your skills for graphic design and video editing? This is perfect for you. We will have our first ever online creative seminar happening every Saturday starting July 11 hanggang August 1. Dito ay tuturo namin yung basic Photoshop, PowerPoint, and video editing. Kung interesado ka, please message us. At dahil new normal, mas active kami ngayon. So please like, follow, subscribe ang aming social media accounts and be updated sa latest happenings. Dito sa Facebook, punta lang kayo sa Unbound City Church. Click follow options at pindutin ang see first para hindi ka na malate sa next live natin. So that's it for now. Up next is the preaching of the word. Let's all be excited as we welcome Unbound City Church lead pastor, Pastor Brandon Ramirez.
Wow, what a great Sunday, everybody. Para sa lahat po na nandito ngayon, we welcome you. We are so happy that you are here joining us again for another service. Why not, before anything else, let's pray together. Come on. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time that you've given us. We thank you, God, that your word is life, your word is truth, you're about to speak to each one of us. Naniniwala po kami na ngayon pa lamang pinagpala mo po ang bawat isa. Allow us, God, to have an open heart, an open mind to whatever it is that you want to speak and what you want to do in our lives. God, we love you, we honor you, we bless your name, Lord. God, use me as your instrument. I am nothing without you, Lord. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Come on, somebody praise God right now, wherever you are. Palakpakan mo si Lord. Come on. Woo. Wow, what a wonderful Sunday. Woo. Grabe yung live audience dito. Buhay na buhay. May mga kumakain pa. Come on. We're happy, you know. Sunday is family day. We really enjoy being together with our families. And I hope that as you are watching right now, you are with your family. Kailangan din nila to. Kailangan nila marinig yung word ni God. You know, kailangan nila na ma-experience yung love ni God, lalo na sa mga panahon po na ito. So, I just want to give a shout out to everybody who's here already. Huwag po kayong mag-alala. Hindi po kayo nagkamali ng pinuntahan. Hindi ko po to page. This is not my vlog. So, I welcome you to Unbound City Church. Andito po ngayon si Ate Reg, si Gore, si Eileen, si Tina, wow, si Kat. Ayan, sino pa po? Si Mama, si Daddy Sid, si Brother Lito and the family. Ayan, si Tita Odette. Welcome po sa inyo. Si Dave. Ayan, wow. Everybody who's here right now, we are so happy that you made yourself available. And I hope that you stay. And now, you still have a chance, you know. Pwede mo pang i-share itong link na to, share mo to sa family mo, share mo to sa wall mo, so that whoever gets to watch it, they may be blessed by God today. So, ngayon pong time ng pandemic, no, marami. Alam niyo po ba, nag-increase yung mga nagpapakabit ng internet. Napakadami mga tao, kailangan nila magpakabit ng internet. No? At iba't ibang Mbps yung kanilang mga pinapakabit, and the higher the better. Yan, gusto nila. May mga bahay na kondo lang sila pero 300 Mbps yung kanila pong speed. Baka balak po nila na bigyan ng internet yung buo nilang floor. Ayan. But you know what? Di ko sinasabi na kapatid ko yun, no? Pero naniniwala po ako, lahat tayo, we are looking for that. We want greater connectivity, you know, higher Mbps. And I believe it's the same thing with our lives. We are called for greater connectivity. So that's the title of what we are talking about right now. It's not just about the internet, you know, but really our lives. We are meant to be connected to one another. We are meant to connect with people, collaborate with people, build a community, build a good family, have the right relationship with the people around us. That's how God had designed you. So I want to tell you po, no, sa oras na to, that if you are that person longing for a meaningful and genuine relationship, walang mali sa'yo. Tama yan. That's what we need in our lives, especially in this season. In trying times, in challenging moments, kailangan natin ng mga totoong tao sa ating pong mga buhay. And so today, I encourage you to dive in together with me into this word. And as we talk about this, let God speak to you. So we're talking about this greater connectivity. What does it mean? In Genesis chapter 2 verse 18, sabi dun, the Lord God said, "It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a helper suitable for him." So paborito tong verse ng mga single, no? And but still, ginag-uusapan natin tong bagay na to, at totoo po to sa buhay natin, it is not good for a man, for a woman, for anyone to be alone. God wants you to have the right people around you. God wants you to have, you know, people that you can trust, people that you can communicate with, people that you can be honest with. I know lahat tayo, we're longing for that kind of relationship. And sa totoo lang, no, it's hard to find nowadays. But is it still available? Does it still exist? Yes. So if you belong to this church and you've been joining the cell groups and the Bible studies, this is what we are having. We're not just building a community, we are building trust, we're building honesty and integrity with one another. Because at the end of the day, ang nais po talaga natin ay genuine relationships. For we know this truth, it is not good for anyone, for any man, for any woman, for anybody to be alone. So if you're not meant to be alone, then what should you do in this season? I'm not saying have a lot of friends or have a lot of followers. Sometimes that's what people have. Sa mga social media accounts nila, ang dami nilang followers. But how many of those followers are your real friends? A lot of people would like your posts, but do they really like you? Or they may like you, but do they love you? It's a different level, it's a different thing. Like doesn't mean love. So, napakahalaga na maintindihan po natin sa mga panahon na ito, we need to evaluate who are we surrounding ourselves with. Maybe you have someone beside you right now. Tignan mo yung tao na yan. Should I be with you? Should I stay with you? Should I live my life with you? We need to be asking these questions. So napaka-importante po, no, para sa bawat isa po sa atin na we get to evaluate properly who we are surrounded with. I believe God created us for this. Number one, community. God created us for community. Some people think, you know, their Christian life is so difficult kasi feeling nila they have to do this alone. No, you don't have to do it alone. You can journey with people. You can journey with us. If there's somebody that you trust who you know is a believer of God, a follower of Jesus Christ, we must have those kind of people sa life po natin because you're not meant to take this journey alone. Kung meron kang, kung pwede kang mag-comment down ngayon sa ating pong live stream, you can type that, I'm not meant to be alone. I'm not meant to be alone. We're not meant to be alone. God wants you to have the right community surrounding you. It's a great impact sa buhay po natin, no? The people that we get to listen to, the voices that we choose to hear, the people that we choose to interact with, they have an impact in our lives, whether we like it or not. Meron silang effect sa buhay po natin. Even the people that we've encountered in the past, even today, we still remember them. Especially the ones who did us bad. You know? Yung mga na-experience natin na hindi maganda, minsan sila yung parang pag naalala mo, hindi mo naman sila nakikita, naalala mo lang pero umiinit yung dugo mo. Why does that happen? It's a reality. It's a truth. Every one of us might have that person na maisip mo lang sa maalala mo lang yung pangalan niya, nangigigil ka na agad. But, you know, what are we called to do? What does God want us to do? As followers, as believers, as Christians. In John chapter 13, verse 34. John 13, verse 34. A new commandment I give you, love one another as I have loved you. So you also must love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples if you love one another. So Jesus spoke these words to his disciples telling them that, hey, ito yung tunay na marka. Kung gusto mong malaman nila na sumusunod ka sa Diyos, sumusunod ka talaga kay Jesus, it is reflected in how you love people, in how you love one another. It's specific pa nga yung sinabi din eh, love one another. Maybe God was speaking, you know, Jesus was speaking to them at that time sa mga disciples. Peter was looking to the other disciple, John looking at the other disciple and telling, you know, I need to love you. I need to really love you. I need to really care about you. Yun daw yung magiging proof ng pagiging totoong disciples. So it's not I'm giving a lot of money in the church. It's not I'm building the church. It's not when you do certain things. It is when we choose to love one another that speaks of how we truly love and follow God. When we are able to love one another, doon daw nagre-reflect, doon daw nakikita ng mga tao, oh, follower to ni Jesus. And in your life right now, maybe if we can have a little checkup, how do you love the people around you? How do you care about the people around you? If you are a follower of Jesus Christ, lumalabas ba mula sa buhay po natin yung pagmamahal ng Diyos? Because that's the good thing about this commandment of God. With this commandment also comes His provision of love. It's telling us, you know, the truth of the matter is, our love, the love that we know, if it's not the love that is from God, it would not be enough to love one another. But when we have the love of God in our hearts, in our lives, recipient tayo, ibig sabihin tumanggap ka ng love ni God, you will be able to pass that on to others. Because you will know how much God has loved you. Kung naintindihan po natin yung tindi ng pagmamahal ni Lord sa atin, gagawin din natin, bibigyan din natin ng kahalagahan yung pagmamahal sa kapwa po natin. But if we don't care about that love, that great love that God has given us, bakit po ganun? When we know the love of God, it's so great a love, and you know na yung love na yun binigay sa'yo ng Diyos, thinking about it, we understand this truth. We are unworthy of that love. We're not worthy of that kind of love. Knowing ourselves, knowing how messed up we are sometimes, knowing, you know, how we do some things that alam naman natin sa mga sarili natin we're not supposed to do. Ang dami nating imperfections. But in the midst of that, we are all still looking for love, right? And it is God, the greatest love of all, showing us that, you know, I still love you despite all those things. I still love you. Even if you've done this, even if you're like this right now, but this is one truth that God wants us to understand. He loves us so much so that He would not allow you to remain the same. He doesn't want to keep you the same. Kung ngayon hindi ka marunong magmahal, now is the right time to know, to understand how it is to love the way that God loves us. Paano ba yun? If we're living in a community, we need to be having this foundation that is love. Romans chapter 12, verse 9. Love must be sincere. Okay? Pag love daw, dapat sincere. Detest what is evil, cling to what is good. That's what love does. Lumalayo sa masama at ginagawa o kinakapitan yung mabuti. You hold on to what is good. Be devoted to one another in brotherly love. Outdo yourselves in honoring one another. Wow! That's kind of difficult to do. Outdo yourselves? Really? Is this really in the Bible? Yes. Outdo yourselves in honoring one another. Do not let your zeal subside. Keep your spiritual fervor serving the Lord. Sinasabi sa atin dito na yung paglalove natin sa kapwa po natin, sa mga kasama natin sa church, kasama natin sa bahay, kasama natin sa community, this is actually our zeal. You know, it speaks of our zeal for spiritual fervor serving the Lord, meaning that the love that we practice, the love that we do, this love is not just an idea, the love is an action word. And itong ginagawa po natin na to, this is actually a spiritual thing. It's not just an emotional thing. Your love must go beyond the emotional. Because if we're only thinking about the emotional stuff about love, you know, it's not always gonna work out when we're talking about love. It's not always gonna work out. Merong mga pagkakataon na you choose to love but they don't love you back. May mga pagkakataon that you've given your all but they've only given 30%, 50%, or whatever it is that they've given. They're not reciprocating the same kind of love that you're giving. And the truth of the matter is, it's unfair. And it's also unfair, you know, how God loves us, but yet a lot of times we don't love Him back. Unfair din yun, tama po ba? But we're all looking for that, you know, real, genuine love. We live for that kind of thing. Outdo yourselves in honoring one another. Now, I was sharing this yesterday sa men's Bible study group namin. It was funny kasi yung experiences namin pagdating sa mga subdivision, mga villages, na kapag nakamotor ka, parang iba yung respeto sa'yo compared sa pag nakasasakyan ka. Na parang habang pag lumiliit lalo yung sasakyan mo, lalong bumababa din yung respeto na pinapakita sa'yo ng mga nagbabantay dun sa gate. You know, why does that happen? Why is it like that? I mean, does it really happen? Yes, it does. You know, same na guard, tapos, you know, same person, ikaw, nakakotse ka, nakasaludo sa'yo, pero pag nakamotor ka na, saan mo dadalhin yan? Naging iba na yung approach. Bakit ganun, no? Because sometimes, this is what we do. We look at the outward appearance. We easily judge people. Instead of loving, ang nagiging default natin bilang mga tao po minsan is love, is judgment instead of love. Ang dali natin mag-judge. Ang dali natin mag-conclude about people instead of showing love first, showing honor first. Honor is not a thing that we easily, you know, give to people. Lalo na pag di natin to naiintindihan. But you know what? Really, that's how it should be. Honoring one another, valuing one another, genuinely outdoing one another in honoring. Wow. Imagine a world like that. Imagine society like that. How peaceful would we be? How respectful would people be? How wonderful would it be to talk to people? And sa pakipag-usap natin, everyone's just, you know, honoring and kind, you know, and wow. I believe that would be a better place to live in, a better house to live in. So, do not let your zeal subside. Keep your spiritual fervor in serving the Lord. Verse 12, be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, persistent in prayer, share with the saints who are in need, practice hospitality. This is the love that God wants us to see in a community. That's what God wants to see in us as a church. How do we love? How do we care for one another? How do we care for those who are in need? Tumutulong ba tayo? No? Do we act on our compassion? If you feel compassion, do you act on it? When you see somebody who is in need, what do you do about that need? Do you do something? Do you help them? Do you reach out? Do you call them and pray for them? Kasi sabi dito, be joyful in hope. Some people may feel na sa mga panahon po na ito, it's hopeless. So hopeless. Hopeless in terms of paano na yung finances natin, paano na yung business natin, paano na yung future natin. It seems hopeless. But then what we are being reminded here is that be joyful in hope. Choose to be joyful in hope. Leave that hopelessness behind and hold on to hope, Jesus Christ, our hope of glory. Be joyful in that. We cannot be joyful if we don't have hope. Patient in affliction. We feel that sometimes what we're going through, what we're facing, parang ang sakit-sakit, so painful. But then, in those seasons, because we choose to love, we choose to be patient. If you're watching with somebody that you love right now, just tell them, I'm choosing to be patient with you. Alright, so, you know, choose to be patient with each other. Choose to be patient with one another. That's what love is about. Love is not about, you know, getting what you want all the time. But being able to give and being able to sacrifice, that's what love is. Patient in affliction, persistent in prayer. When things don't work out, don't easily give up. Pray. Persistently pray. Hindi lahat ng mga bagay madadaan natin sa lakas natin. Minsan, sa lakas din ng iyak. Minsan, sa paglohod natin at pag-amin, sa lakas ng loob natin na pag-amin, that, you know, things are difficult. I don't know what to do anymore. What would it take for you to kneel down in prayer, come before God in humility? What moment are you waiting for before you actually humble yourself down before God? That's how we are able, you know, to also be patient with other people, to love others. Because when we understand that truth, na si God nga eh, ang tagal niyang hinihintay na manalangin ka. And sometimes for us, you know, gusto natin yung mga tao, instantly when we want them, they would be there for us. But my question is, when God wants you, do you ever come to Him? Do you ever get close to Him? Do you ever make that decision that, you know, I'm gonna wake up earlier this morning because I want to spend time in the Word of God. I want to spend time in prayer. I want to spend time in worship. But when things suddenly become difficult, you know, minsan, we're not, we have to wait for moments like that bago lang tayo lumapit sa Panginoon and really decide, God, I want you in my life. So I give up. I don't know what to do anymore. But hey, anyway, kahit ganun pa naman din, He still chooses to love us. He still chooses to be with us. 1 John chapter 3, by this we know what love is. Alright, ito yung love na explanation in the biblical sense. Jesus laid down His life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for our brothers. Wow! This is love? Seriously? Ito talaga yung pagmamahal? Ito ba talaga? Bakit parang ang hirap? Parang hindi naman yan yung love. Bakit ganito? If anyone with earthly possessions sees his brother in need but withholds his compassion from him, how can the love of God abide in him? Little children, let us love not in word and speech but in action and truth. Wow. Sobrang pambasag to ng mga kaisipan po natin o ng ating mga pananaw patungkol sa kung ano ba yung pagmamahal. Because what we're talking about here is we do not love in just word and speech. Because people can tell you how much they love you. They will say to you, I love you 1,000 times, 100 times. Pero how much do they really love you? Hindi tayo maniniwala sa dami ng I love you pero wala namang ginagawa for you. I don't think we will ever believe love that is only confessed but not act upon. Love is really about us doing something when we see people in need, when we see that the ones that we love are hurting, we hurt with them. When they are happy, we enjoy with them. Right? So we really want to practice the real kind of love that speaks and moves, cares about people, cares about one another, being able to sacrifice yourself because it's what Jesus did. That's what love is. Jesus laid down His life for us. Maybe this is what we need to understand. We will only know na naiintindihan na natin yung pagmamahal if we already have that, you know, feeling and decision within us that I would give my life for this person. I would give my life for her. I would give my life for my child. Maybe that's the only time na masasabi natin, wow, now I understand what love is. Because I'm willing to give myself. I'm willing to sacrifice myself. Sacrifice my wants. Sacrifice my preferences. So I can serve my family. So I can serve my community. That's how we know that we know love. Right? This is what love is. Di mo na kailangan kumanta. You wanna know what love is? The Bible really already speaks about it. Jesus laying down His life. Boom. That's it. Yun po ang love. Number one is community. Number two is collaboration. We were meant to work together, collaborate with one another. Not hate, but collaborate. What we want is for each one of us to know, hey, ano yung strength mo? Or ano yung weakness mo? Maybe I can help you with that. Or saan ka magaling? Wow, magaling ka pala dyan. Mahina ako dyan eh. Then, you know, can you help me? I believe that we are all meant to work together. We're not meant to compare. Because when people don't collaborate, one of the reasons is I don't want to collaborate because I keep on comparing myself to this person. And what I see in this person is not a collaborator but a competitor. And when that is the case, we find it difficult to work with one another. I believe we as a church also has a call, you know? We have a call to collaborate, even with other churches, with other Christians. That's why we're doing different kinds of ministries that connects us with other churches as well. Kasi I believe that, I strongly believe that as a pastor of a church, our job is not just to, you know, to just hide everybody inside the church. And tayo-tayo na lang hanggang sa dulo. But I believe we grow when we collaborate. We grow and we know that we have matured when we are able to work with others. Because we're not insecure. Because we're not comparing ourselves. We're not trying to compete with anybody. But all that we want to do is to speak of the gospel, evangelize to people, tell the truth about the word of God. Hindi natin kailangan makipaglaban sa ibang mga simbahan. But what we're actually doing right now is we collaborate where we can learn things, we learn from them. Where we can share something, we share what we have with them. And I believe that should be the spirit of, you know, the church today. Now is not the time for the church to be divided. Lalo na kung isang church lang tayo. For us, Unbound City Church, if you are unbound, do not allow yourself to be bound by the thought of competition and comparison. Allow yourself to grow by collaborating with one another, because that's what the Word of God says. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 12. There is one body, but it has many parts. But all its many parts make up one body. It is the same with Christ. We were all baptized by one Holy Spirit, and so we are formed into one body. It didn't matter whether we were Jews or Gentile, slaves or free people. We were all given the same Spirit to drink. So the body is not made up of just one part. It has many parts. Brothers and sisters, you know, families out there, you have a part in this. There's something that you must do in this. Naalala ko na nagsistart pa lang ito pong, you know, yung pandemic. And I was the one operating lahat po ng mga techie stuff sa church. And pag-service na, no? Hindi ko na iniisip kung ano yung itsura ko. Basta kailangan ma-operate na to lahat, no? O sa ang importante, mailabas yung mensahe. But you know what? Kahit papaano, ngayon po nakakaligo na ako bago mag-service. Bakit? Kasi may nag-ooperate na, may iba na nag-ooperate. At matindi nun, may tinitrain pa na pangalawa pang mag-ooperate din. Praise God for that, no? Unbound na ako doon sa gawain. But you know what? Why does that happen sometimes? Sometimes pastors think that all the job is on their shoulders. It shouldn't be the case. Maybe at the beginning, meron talagang mga point of, you know, sacrifice that you have to make. But then at the end, you know, as we grow further, napaka-importante that we know how to delegate and trust everybody in working together. Know the strengths of each person in the church and let them serve in a ministry that you know God is calling them to, or they know na dito sila tinatawag ni Lord. Don't stop them from experiencing the full potential of their gifts coming from God. So, we are one body with many parts. Sabi dito sa verse 15, suppose the foot says, I'm not a hand, so I don't belong to the body. But saying this, it cannot stop being part of the body. Kahit sabihin daw ng paa, hindi naman ako kamay, so hindi ako parte ng katawan. No, kahit nasabihin pa ng paa mo yon, pero okay, unang point, nakakatakot yung nagsasalitang paa. But, you know, anyway, understanding this na pag sinabi daw nung paa na hindi ako kamay, so hindi ako kasali, no, it doesn't disqualify you. You're still a part of the body. Kasama ka pa rin. So kahit sabihin mo, siguro ito yun eh. Kahit sabihin mo na, oh, hindi ko po yan kaya. Okay, hindi mo yan kaya, pero it doesn't mean na hindi ka parte. Meron ka pa rin pwedeng gawin. Pero hindi mo lang gagawin kung ano yung ginagawa nung kamay. Kung paa ka, maging paa ka. Guess mo yun, mga kapaa? No? So lahat po, no, ng parte, iba't ibang parte tayo, pero lahat tayo, meron tayong responsibilidad na gawin yung parte na yon. We don't have to compare with each other. Not everybody needs to preach. Not everybody needs to lead worship. Not everybody needs to be on the media team. Not everybody needs to be in the children's ministry. You know, every single one of us have a different part, and we must be able to recognize that. I believe this is the season for us to do that. Saan tayo magaling, or saan ka burdened, you know? May nararamdaman ka na parang, you know, pag yung isang bagay na to na nakita mo ginagawa ng ibang tao and they're not doing it right, but you know how to do it, maybe that's your calling. Maybe that's one thing that you need to work on. Maybe you're called to do that. You get that? Yung mga umiinis sa'yo, you know, yung mga nakikita mo na parang, pwedeng ganito yan eh, pwede pang mas okay yung ganito. Maybe that frustration is a sign of God's calling over your life. Na-frustrate ka because you know it can be done in a better way. And maybe it's you. You're the one that God's calling to do it in a better way. God has placed each part in the body just as He wanted it to be. Verse 18. If all the parts were the same, how could there be a body? Exactly. Imagine a body na lahat ng parte ng kanyang katawan ay paa lang. That's not a body at all. Right? So, imagine that. everybody's the same. No, that's not how it's meant to be. So yung diversity natin, yung differences natin, is actually a purposeful difference that we have. Intentional yung differences na meron tayo. Intentional yung diversity na inalaw ni God na magkaroon yung bawat isa po sa atin. Kaya tayo iba-iba kasi may iba-iba tayong parte. May iba-iba tayong responsibilidad. May iba-iba tayong panawagan. So, you get what we're talking about here? So verse 23, the parts that we think are less important, ito, kung feeling mo hindi ka mahalaga, we treat with special honor. Wow! Those that we don't see, we treat with special honor. Akala natin hindi mahalaga. It's like, you know, yung internal organs natin. Akala natin, no, ito hindi kasi siya nakikita, hindi siya exposed. Pero hindi ba ito mahalaga? Yun nga yung mas mahalaga eh. Yun nga yung pag nagkasakit, ang mahal-mahal. Tama, yung internal organs natin. I believe the same thing with the church. The prayer ministries in the church, the intercessory team of the church, the things that we do in secret, the things that we do behind the scenes, yung mga bagay na yun are so important in building up the church, in building up the community. And we don't disregard those things. We are working together, we're collaborating, we're doing yung mga bagay na yun na kahit hindi nakikita ng iba, gagawin pa rin natin. Kapatid, is that you? Even if nobody sees what you're doing, would you still do it? Because I'm telling you this, it is still important. It's not the audience that makes what you do important. It is God who sees what you do in secret. It is God who sees what you do behind the scenes. That matters a lot. It's like what happens right now, itong nakikita nyo po ngayon is already the service, the broadcast. But before this, a lot was going on. Sa sala namin, the worship team was praying, they're having their devotion, reading the Word of God. And while they were doing that, I was upstairs, I was kneeling down and praying to God. Why do we do that? Because itong public ministry po na ginagawa po natin, itong broadcast po na ito, it will all rely on what we do in private. It would all rely on what we do in secret. Because this is not just an ordinary organization, we are a church. So as we are doing this, yung mga bagay na hindi nakikita, kapatid, yun talaga yung mahalaga. Sobrang halaga ng mga bagay na ito that we should not neglect doing them. Our prayer time, our devotion time, our worship time, our personal moments with God matters a lot. The things that other people don't see. People can judge you now with what you do, but they don't see, you know, the hard work that you're doing behind the scenes when they're not watching. Yun ang napakahalaga. So we are looking at this, no? In verse 25, in that way, the parts of the body will not take sides. All of them will take care of one another. If one part suffers, every part suffers with it. If one part is honored, every part shares in its joy. So everybody enjoys when one part wins. When one part is doing something, everybody, you know, should celebrate together. It's not like, oh, bakit siya lang yung gumagawa niyan? Bakit ako, hindi ako? Bakit siya lagi yung napipili? Oh, bakit siya lagi yung lumalabas? Bakit si Kuya Kenneth palagi yung updates? Bakit hindi naman kami? You know, that's not the way that we wanna operate and collaborate in the church. We will have our own time. But are you faithful in secret? Are you faithful behind the scenes? Some people want to say na, nako, kung ako yung nandyan, kung ako yung nagpipreach, kung ako yung nagbo-broadcast, kung ako yung tumatayo dyan, I would do this, I would do that. But the question is, what do you do behind the scenes? What do you do in secret? That would matter a lot. The time that you're hidden, just like a picture, yung mga camera before, pag nag-take sila ng picture, kailangan mong i-develop sa dark room before you see the picture, because you, and in that picture, you don't want it to be exposed prematurely. Kasi pag premature yung exposure, nasisira yung picture. The same thing with our lives. There is a time for preparation before we actually do that collaboration. Before we step into that position, we must first be prepared in that dark room, in that behind the scenes. We work on it. So, verse 27, you are the body of Christ. Each one of you is a part of it. Wala daw hindi kasama. We are all part of it. And bilang tayo ay may part, we're supposed to be doing something today. If you are watching this right now and you are blessed with what you're watching, you know, maybe later on after this or maybe right now at this very moment, you can share this on your timeline. You can share this on your page. You can share this to your friends or to your families. That's also doing your part. Spreading the gospel, spreading a good news. Kung kaya mong mag-spread ng meme, bakit hindi ng church broadcast? I believe all of us, you know. I mean, memes are funny. I share them too. But it's important for us to understand, no, the things that really matters at the end of the day. Your soul, our spirit. What feeds that? What do you feed it with today? This word can feed your spirit. This word can feed your soul. This word can encourage you, can bless you, can save somebody today. Why are we not sharing it? Why are we not going out? And you know what? Maybe after this, you have reflections about this word. Why not go and vlog about it afterwards? I-share mo sa mga tao na nandun sa profile mo, people who can see what you post. Post about this preaching afterwards. Do your part. We all have a part in this. Everybody can do something in this season. We cannot wait for things to be okay. You know, we were supposed to broadcast sa church na po today, no? But it didn't happen kasi hindi dumating yung magkoconnect ng internet. I'm not gonna say the name of the provider, no? I'm not gonna give any clues anyway. But still, you know, hindi dumating yung provider. Hindi kinonek, pero nagsabi sila na Saturday. So we are all excited to broadcast sa church, but then it didn't happen. So if that's the case, okay, hindi nangyari yun. So anong gagawin ko? I have to bring all the stuff back here. But it's okay. Why? Because we have our purpose. Our preference is that we do that sa church. We do this, broadcast sa church, but it didn't happen. But our purpose remains, you know, higher than our preference. If it cannot happen there, it can still happen here. We can still do it here. Because the place doesn't matter anymore as long as there's someone like you listening to this message, you are hearing God's word, and God is touching your heart, changing your life, then wherever we can do this, we will do it. If you give us the opportunity, we might do this at your home. Kung meron kayong malakas na internet sa bahay po ninyo. But you know what? It's so important that we keep our minds in our purpose. Keep ourselves in our purpose. Because when all other else, you know, anything, some things in your life doesn't work out, still, you go back to your purpose. And then you will have direction. Then you will know where to start again. Where to go from where you are right now. So, community, collaboration, and the last point is this, inner circle. You are not meant to be alone. You have your friends, you have people following you, but do you have an inner circle? Do you have people, the right people surrounding your life? This inner circle could be just a few people in your life, pero sila yung solid na mga tao na pinagkakatiwalaan mo talaga. Their voice are voices that you value, and at the same time, they also value your voice. And they value you as a person. Your inner circle. Who is in your inner circle today? Maybe we can check that out. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 33. Do not be deceived. Bad company corrupts good character. Bad company corrupts good character. If you surround yourself with bad company, then what would be the effect? Bad character. Bad behavior. Have you heard of somebody na dati hindi naman ganun yung ugali niya, pero because he was surrounded by, you know, so-called friends of his, and then all of a sudden, naging iba yung ugali niya, naging iba yung perspective niya sa buhay? Because the truth remains, you know, bad company corrupts good character. This company, these people that we surround ourselves with, will have an impact over our lives, will change our behavior, would change our perspective, would change our lifestyle. So we need to be careful. Kailangan po natin i-evaluate sino ang hinahayaan natin sa buhay po natin. Right? If we are connecting with the right people, praise God. But if you are connecting with those people, if you are connected with people right now that, you know, alam mo na hindi sila okay, start praying for them. I'm not gonna tell you to cancel them out. I'm not gonna tell you to just just cut them off that quickly. Pray for them. Trust that God can still do a work in them as you allow yourself to be worked on by God also. Yun naman din yung isang bagay na dapat po nating tandaan, because today people can just, you know, easily cancel you, you know, cut you off in their lives. There's this so-called cancel culture, but cancel culture is not kingdom culture. Cancel culture is not kingdom culture. That's not what, you know, I believe Jesus Christ is teaching us. He's teaching us to love one another, care for one another. If you see somebody who's not doing okay right now, well, we all have a point in our lives where we've done some things. But we're happy that we're not canceled. You know, cancel culture is okay until it's you being canceled. Pero sa mga sarili po natin, we need to be careful. We don't just easily cut off relationships. If you really value people in your lives, if you have that inner circle and there's real trust and honesty there, kung merong mga hindi pagkakasunduan, talk about it. If may mga character flaws that needs to be, you know, called out, call it out. Don't cancel out, call it out. Talk about it. Be brave enough. If you really care for one another, pag-usapan natin yung mga sablay so that we can change how we're living. We can change how we're behaving with each other. We can change our attitude. We can change, you know, how we live our lives. And still doing it together, journeying together, right? Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verse 9 to 12. Two are better than one because they have a good return for their labor. If either of them falls down, one can help the other up. But pity anyone who falls and has no one to help them up, right? So we are being prepared to have this inner circle in our lives, people that we trust, maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you know, 8 people sa buhay mo who talagang sobrang solid yung relationship ninyo. You really trust them, you really love them, and you know that they really love you too. Ito yung mga tao na pag nadapa ka, sila yung unang tatawa, pero itatayo ka rin nila. Alam mo yun? Sometimes when that happens, you know, we make a mistake. Sometimes we laugh it off. Sometimes we make a mistake. It's so difficult. Ang hirap tumayo. Fine. Pick up that person. Reach out your hand. If that's you, allow the people that you trust to pick you up right now. Kung merong bagay ngayon sa buhay mo na nagpapahina sa'yo and you feel so weak and empty and lost and, you know, kahit na ano pa po yung pakiramdam na yan, God will give you the right people, this inner circle that will help you. They will help you stand up again. Clearly sinasabi dito sa Book of Ecclesiastes that ito yung purpose ng mga tao po sa paligid natin, so that they will pick us up when we fall down. Why? Because falling down is real. Falling down is real. Madadapa tayo, matutumba tayo, there will be those moments in our lives. And it's sad when that happens, but nobody picks you up. Nobody reaches out to you. Nobody tells you that, hey, we can work on it. Hey, you know what? It's not yet over. The fight is not yet over. We can still do something about that situation. Tara, magpray tayo. Tara, ipagkatiwala natin yan sa Panginoon. We need that today. We need that kind of relationship today. In verse 11, also, if two lie down together, they will keep warm. But how can one keep warm alone? Though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strands is not quickly broken. You see? The more that there's somebody that you can trust, more that, you know, you are connected with these people, you become stronger. You become a unit. You are able to face whatever. May mga tama kang kasama, may mga kaagapay ka sa mga panahon na to. You need that in your life. We want to be there for you too. That's why in the church, we have our Bible studies. We have our group, you know, our cell groups. You can be a volunteer, join the volunteers group, and there we will help you develop leadership and, you know, collaboration skills. Why do we do that in church? Because we believe that we are meant to work together. Because we know that when we work together, we are stronger. When we are valuing each other, that's when we truly see that we are living, you know, a life that pleases God, that honors God, right? So, collaborate, work with each other, and have, you know, that inner circle in your life. How can we develop a good inner circle sa life po natin? Look at the parts of your life where you're weak at. At kung saan ka mahina, find people who are strong on that aspect. And then, let them teach you how to be strong in those parts of your lives. And at the same time, I hope that you become a part of somebody's inner circle where you're the one helping out. We pass it on. We work together. Especially in faith. Especially in our journey in Christianity. Napakahalaga na meron tayong mga kasama. Malapit na po ako magtapos. So hold on. How do we connect well with others? How do we connect well with the people around us? I believe this is the key. Colossians chapter 1, verse 15. The Son is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn over all creation. For in Him all things were created, things in heaven and on earth, visible and invisible. Whether thrones or powers or rulers or authorities, all things have been created through Him and for Him, Jesus Christ. He is before all things, and in Him, this is the key part, in Him all things hold together. He is the head of the body, the church. He is the beginning and the firstborn from among the dead, so that in everything He might have the supremacy. For God was pleased to have all His fullness dwell in Him, and through Him to reconcile to Himself all things, whether things on earth or things in heaven, by making peace through His blood shed on the cross. See that? The key to community, the key to collaboration, the key to having an effective inner circle is making sure that Jesus Christ is the center of it all. Jesus Christ at the center of it all. Why? Because we may be surrounded by a lot of things. Surrounded by troubles, surrounded by challenges, surrounded by problems, surrounded by pain. But in the midst of all that, we know and we trust that our God is bigger. Our God is stronger. Our God is able. There may be troubles in my life today, but I know that my God is able to bring me through it. And a lot of times, God will show His power through the people surrounding you. Have you ever experienced that? Yung lugmok na lugmok ka, problemado ka, but then you start praying with someone. Or maybe yung time na may problema ka, suddenly someone calls you, a friend, a pastor, a leader, calls you and then reminds you, hey, God just told me to call you right now. You know, I just felt led to pray with you right now. Can I pray for you? And then all of a sudden, you felt strength. All of a sudden, you felt peace. All of a sudden, all those things that are surrounding you left the room. And now you're surrounded by the presence of God. This is how we fight our battles. How? Together. We do this together. We're not going to do it alone. We're not going to do it on our own. We're going to trust that it is God who is with us in the midst of it all. He is with us in the fire. He is with us in the water. He is with us through it all. I know for sure. Merong nanonood sa mga oras na to and you feel like you've been alone all these years. But right now, I pray that through this church, you find a community that's willing to collaborate with you. And here you can find an inner circle that will support you in your journey, in knowing Christ and in following Jesus. Why not we just come before God right now in worship and in prayer, believing that He is with us, understanding that as we trust in Him right now, He will never leave us. He will never forsake us. We know that there's another in the fire. Jesus Christ is with us. You know why I love this song? I remember si Shadrach, si Meshach, si Abednego, where it's really the foundation for this song. Yung sabi dun sa song na yun that, you know, there is another in the fire. Also in the Bible, there were three of them, the Hebrew boys, thrown, you know, they were thrown into the fire. But in the furnace, all of a sudden, now they were four. There was the fourth man, and it was God with them. That moment right there, powerful moment. God showed up at that moment. Help them, save them through the fire. I don't know what fire you're in today, but I want to remind you of this. You are not alone. You are not doing this on your own. We can trust God together. We can go through this together. There may be breaking, but understand this, that there will never be breakthroughs when there's no breaking that happens to you. Why would you need a breakthrough if you were never broken in the first place? These moments are the moments where we need the right people the most. The moments where we really need God the most. You are in the midst of us, God, right now. Wherever you are. Fire. Standing next to me. There is another in the waters. Holding back the seas. And should I ever need reminding what power set me free? There is a grave that holds nobody. Power lives in me. There's another in the fire. Standing next to me is another in the waters. Holding back the seas. And should I ever need reminding what power set me free? There is a grave that holds nobody. The power lives in me. I can see the light in the darkness as the darkness bows to Him. I can hear the roar in the heavens as the space between wears thin. I can feel the ground shake beneath us as the prison walls cave in. Nothing stands between us. One more time. I can see the light. I can see the light in the darkness as the darkness bows to Him. I can hear the roar in the heavens as the space between wears thin. I can feel the ground shake beneath us as the prison walls cave in. Nothing stands between us. Nothing stands between us. Nothing. Nothing stands between us. Nothing stands between. There is another end of fire. Thank you, Lord. You are in the midst of it all. Love me free. Body. Father, as we come to you right now, God, we trust that you see the depths of our hearts. You know what we really need. You know what we really desire. You know the need in our lives for the right people to surround us. But even if there are those of us at this moment na feeling talaga namin mag-isa lang kami sa mga panahon po na ito, God, I pray for them right now. I pray for strength. I pray for grace. I pray that you break whatever it is that is hindering us from collaborating with people, from allowing ourselves to be involved in a community, for allowing ourselves not just to join a church, but to journey with people. Lord, now is the season for us to not be alone, but instead know that you want us to have the right people in our lives. Speak to us, God, at this moment. We know na meron ka namang inihanda para sa bawat isa sa amin. Mga tamang tao who would speak into our lives, who trusts us, who would believe in us. Some of us have lost the desire to collaborate because there was so much hate in your life by people that you feel like you have failed in the past. You have experienced that, you know, people have trusted you and you failed, and then they started marking you that you are your failure. But I want to tell you this right now, you are not your failures, and you are not a failure. And don't ever think that you failed God. No. You have an opportunity to come to Him in humility. You have an opportunity to build up yourself again now, this time in the right community, with the right people, those who will not judge you and those who will love you, those who would care about you, those who would truly value you, those who would believe in you. Again, I just want to say to somebody right now, we believe in you. We still believe that you can make it. We still believe that you can do it. I believe that by the grace of God, His power, His grace, His strength upon your life will enable you to stand up from where you have fallen down. Marami sa atin, we've fallen down and made mistakes, but I want to tell you right now, you are not your mistake. God is taking you again. God's embracing you again. God is calling you again and showing you that there's a new path He had prepared for you. You were never disqualified for the future that He had for you. In the first place, you have no power in this world to stop you from seeing that destiny that God has for you. We're not that powerful. We're not powerful enough to stop God's plans. God's plans will still push through even without you, but now He's calling you because He wants you to be a part of it. Because when you become a part of it, that's when you are satisfied. That's when you are complete. That's when you have life. That's when you see the full potential that God has put in your life, in your being. God designed you, and therefore He knows what you are for. God designed you, therefore He knows the purpose that He has for you, and only He can give you what you need and what you're looking for to this day. Don't stop yourself from coming to God. Hindi ito baduy. Hindi ito kahinaan. This is what you need in your life. You need God of all those things that you're trying to fix today and you feel like it's unfixable. I can't do anything about it anymore, but God's telling you right now, my child, I can still do something about it. I can still work it out. I can show you how powerful I am. Only believe, only trust. Hallelujah. Father, I thank you for everybody under the sound of my voice. Right now, I know that you are touching their hearts. I believe, God, that you've spoken a word to them and have sparked a fire within them. Bakit ka hindi apektado ng apoy, Panginoon? It's because you are that fire, that strong fire, unquenchable fire. Ikaw yung Panginoon, you're a fire stronger than the fires that we're in. That's who you are. That's why you're not afraid of the fire. And we too, as your children, as your people, we're not afraid of the fire. Let it come. For with us is the unquenchable fire that is you, Lord. We honor you, God, and we bless your name. So I want to pray right now for somebody watching this for the first time, maybe first time mo lang na sumama ngayon, and I want to thank you for being here. Kapatid, I want to welcome you to this family. I want you to see that there is a destiny that God has prepared for you, but more than that, He wants to build a relationship with you. So as you are watching this today, I want to tell you this. God loves you. He had always loved you. He never stopped loving you. And maybe today you can welcome Him in your life. Let Him lead you. Let Him show you the way. Because maybe you've been trying to do it on your own for a long time. But right now, let Him in. Let Him show you how to do it. Let Him show you how to live. As you listen to Him, I believe that you will find life in God. God, I pray for this brother, this sister who's watching right now. I pray for your grace and your mercy, that they would understand, Lord, that there's forgiveness for all of their sins. There's forgiveness for all that they've done in this life and even the sins that they'll do in the future. But God, you will be with them and will strengthen them. You will show them that they can have a new life with you. They can be unbound. No longer bound by the desires of the world, no longer bound by selfishness, no longer bound by worldliness, but instead unbound, free indeed, free in Christ. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Why not everybody raise up your hand right now? I want to release a blessing. Just want to pray for everybody watching right now. God, your favor, your blessing be upon each one of us. I release this blessing upon you in the name of Jesus. May He bless whatever it is that your hands work on, whatever it is, your job, your business, all these things that you are entrusting to God. He has the power to bless and make it multiply. Marami pong salamat, Panginoon, that you bless our families, our water, our supply, our everything. It is you, Lord, who is the provider of everything. You are a good, good Father to us. Lord, we honor you. We bless your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Praise God. Yeah. Wow. That was good. Amen. So, you know, for everybody watching right now, if you're still here, please do message us so you can get the Zoom link for the Sunday Zoom in. We want to get to know you. Please do message us. We invite you to join our Bible studies yung for the men, for the youth, for the women. Lahat po ng ito, no, these are all for you. We want to connect with each one of you. So, please join these groups, these activities that we have in our church. So, I hope you join us again next week. Thank you, everyone. God bless you. Have a powerful week ahead. We are Unbound.